Speak louder then. Can you hear me now? All right. So the title is actually that came from my son. So I was telling him what I'm going to talk about. He's a matric, and he thought that was an exciting title. So that's what I'll talk about. But there's a boring version of the title as well, and that's that one. Okay, my name was on the previous slide, by the way. I should introduce myself, Petri Väisänen. I'm an astronomer, have been an astronomer from probably when I was 12 years old. Then later on studied it as well, and it was never really a big decision for me. I wanted to pursue astronomy since I was a really little kid. And I'm very privileged that I actually ended up being an astronomer and get to play with really large telescopes. I had a 14-centimeter, 15-centimeter small telescope when I was a 13-year-old, 14-year-old kid. And now I get to do the SALT big telescope in Sutherland. But I'll talk about maybe the biggest event in astronomy that happened last year, maybe the biggest event of the decade, in fact, if not longer than that. Something about gravitational waves, multi-messenger astronomy. That's going to be the big chunk of my talk. But then I'll also touch on the theme of the SNIPRS, right? So that's on the innovation 4.0, which many of you will know that refers to the industrial fourth industrial revolution, really, of the whole society us transferring into putting together technology in totally innovative ways, biology, physics, computers, meshing humans with machines, intelligence, artificial intelligence, all of that, and what that means. Talk a little bit about what that means in our context in Sutherland and Cape Town in South African astronomy. How do we use that, and what the relevance over there is? And then the last bit is about exoplanets, searching for life in the universe. And all of these things are something which are very much in the cutting edge of astronomy worldwide, but also in South Africa. Let me introduce first the institute I'm from. That I have the privilege of leading at the moment. It's the SAO, or South African Astronomical Observatory. It's actually going to turn 200 years in 2 years. It was established 1820, so we'll have a big splash in 2020, celebrating astronomy and science in general in the whole country, and hopefully here as well, and in universities around the world, around the country, in schools. And we'll have events in our facility, of course, as well. But we are a research facility. We train students, we have researchers, we have a lot of other staff. There are about 130, I think, altogether at SAO, altogether, and we split between two sites in Cape Town and in Sutherland. That's what it looks like, except for the grass. It is not green at all at the moment. It's very, very yellow. I know that there's water shortages elsewhere in the country as well, but maybe we have it worse in Cape Town, and I was very much enjoying my shower this morning, having it a little bit longer than I have back home. So thank you for that as well. And go see the exhibits. There's SAO, SKA, SALT, there's astronomy, there's a whole room over there. I'm sure most of you have been there already, but if you haven't, please go and check out the team. Part of the team is actually sitting over here. Presenting astronomy and what's happening in astronomy in the student realm and public awareness. So most of the people are in Cape Town in that facility, but then we run the work itself, the meat of the whole subject, what we do is actually in Sutherland. So all the telescopes are in Sutherland, about 400 kilometers from Cape Town in the Karoo region.